Growing up, some of the most fun I've had with video games has been with casual golf games. One day I saw someone on the Unity Discord saying they couldn't find any mini golf tutorials on YouTube, so I decided to have a go at it. It kind of turned into a multi-day thing because I was having so much fun, and I think there's a lot to share about what I learned when making this prototype. In this video, we'll go over the fundamentals of creating a system that allows players to click the ball and drag it in a direction to add a force. Before you go, make sure to hit those like and subscribe buttons. It's absolutely free and it helps the channel a ton. I have my project set up here with my ball and a little enclosed area. The game objects that create the enclosed area all have colliders attached to them, and on my ball I've attached a sphere collider and a rigid body. On the rigid body I've checked use gravity and I've unchecked is kinematic. I've also set interpolate to interpolate so that things are a little bit smoother if we decide to make a camera follow the ball at any point, and I've also set my collision detection to continuous dynamic. The mass, drag, and angular drag will all change how the physics work with your ball, so feel free to experiment with them. The same can be said for all of the physics materials that have been applied to each of the colliders. Under our ball game object, we've also attached a line game object which contains a line renderer. In order to get our ball to move when we click, let's create a new script. I'll go to Add Component, New Script, and name this Line Force. Then I'll click Create and Add. Unity will attach that script to our game object, and within our project in the Assets folder, it'll place that script. I'll just drag this to our Scripts folder to maintain organization. On our game object, I'll double click this Line Force to open this in Visual Studio. Let's get started by visualizing our line. So for a variable, let's get a private line renderer. We'll call it line renderer. And we'll want to assign it in the inspector, so we'll make a serialized field here. Then I'll make a private void draw line function, which will take in the parameter of a vector 3, which will be the world point. So on our line renderer, we'll do a set positions equal to positions, which we'll make in a second, and set the line renderer enabled equal to true so that it shows. Above this, we'll make a local vector 3 array called positions. We'll set it equal to the current transform position of our game object and the world point that we take in. So in this particular case, the transform.position will be the center of the object that we're drawing from. In this case, it'll be the center of our ball, and the world point will be our click location. In order to get our click location, we're going to do some raycasting. I'm going to copy and paste a method we've used in a previous video. I won't detail it too much here because we've already gone over it in that video. There's a link in the description below to the timestamp of when we talk about that in case you want to learn a little bit more. But as a really quick overview of what's going on here, we're measuring where our mouse click is on the near and far clip planes of the camera. Then we're casting a ray between those two points to see if it hit any colliders. If it did, we return the point at which it hit. If it didn't, we return null. That's why here we're returning a vector 3 that is nullable. Now we'll call both of these in an update function. So I'll make a private void update, and I'll make a vector 3 that is nullable called world point here, which will be equal to our method. Then I'll call an if here. If not, world point has value. If not, then we'll return. So what this is doing is saying, if there's no value for world point, don't even worry about continuing into the rest of the code here and just return. Returns like this are helpful so that you avoid nested if statements. So if our world point has a value, then we'll call draw line at the world point value. Back in Unity on our ball script, we need to assign our line renderer. We'll assign it to that slot. Then I'll click play to play test. Now you can see every frame, a line is drawn from the center of my game object to where my current mouse input intersects a collider. And this works when you change your camera angle. But We don't want this line to show up all the time. We only want it to show up when we've clicked on our ball and when our ball is stationary. So back in our script, let's add a couple booleans. I'll add a private bool is idle and a private bool is aiming. Then I'll make a new private void on mouse down for if is idle is aiming equals true. What this means is that when we click on our object, which in this case is our ball, we'll check if our object is idle, and if it is, we'll allow ourselves to aim. I'll also make a new method for process aim. Within this, I'll make an if statement for if we're not aiming, or if we're not idle, we'll return. And I'll move our functionality from update into this method. Then in update, I'll put our process aim function. So every frame we'll do a check for if our ball is moving, or if we haven't clicked on our ball to enable aiming, we'll just exit out of this function early. Now we need to set our idle state. For that, we'll need our rigid body. So I'll make a new private rigid body and call it rigid body. Then on awake, I'll set my rigid body equal to get component rigid body. While we're here, I'll also set is aiming equal to false by default. And to ensure that my line render isn't drawing things that we don't want it to, we'll set our enabled equal to false. Now in our update, I'll make an if statement that will check our rigid body dot velocity dot magnitude to see if it is less than our stop velocity. We'll have to make a new variable for our stop velocity as well. So I'll declare a private float stop velocity and set it equal to 0.05f. And I'll want to see this in inspector in case we want to change it. So I'll serialize this field. So this will check whether our ball is below a certain speed that we set. If it is, that's when we'll consider the ball stopped or idle. But we actually want to make sure that it's stopped. So I'm going to call a stop method here that we haven't created, and then I will create it. So I'll make a private void stop. And when we call stop, we will set our rigid body velocity equal to vector 3, 0. So we're stopping the velocity, and we'll do the same for our angular velocity. And then we'll set our is idle equal to true. Now when we playtest, we don't start with a line render, but when we click on our ball, it starts to draw a line and it matches our cursor position. Now what we need to do is add our force. In our process aim method under draw line, I'll add an if statement here for if input get mouse button up 0. And this will check if our left mouse click has been raised. If it has, I'm going to call a shoot function that we'll make, and it will take in the same world point dot value. I'll create a private void shoot with a vector 3 world point. I'll set my is aiming equal to false. I'll disable my line render. Then I'll make a new vector 3 horizontal world point and set it equal to a new vector 3, which will be our world point X. And then we'll use our transform position Y and then our world point Z. Because of the way that we have things set up, our raycast can be in any vertical space. But what that means is that if we're clicking on something that is vertically above our ball, there will be a vertical force that gets applied. So instead of our using our world point directly, we'll just use our transform. This ensures that the velocity that's getting applied is always horizontal with our game object. From our horizontal world point, we'll be able to get the direction. So we'll get a vector 3. We'll call this direction. We'll set it equal to the difference of our horizontal world point and our transform .position, and we'll do a .normalize so it has a magnitude of 1. And then we'll also calculate the strength, which we'll set equal to the vector3.distance, and we'll put in our transform.position and our horizontal world point. And then we'll add that to our rigid body. So we'll do a rigid body dot add force, and we'll put in our direction. We'll multiply it by our strength. And then we will also multiply it by our shot power, which will be a value we'll set. So up at the very top, I'll copy my stop velocity because I'm gonna have another variable here. But instead of stop velocity, I will make this my shot power. Then back in Unity on my ball, I will assign a shot power of 150. And this is just a number that you can experiment with to get different strengths of the force that you're adding. Now when I click play, I can drag and shoot my ball in any direction that I want. However, you'll notice that while I'm shooting, I can still shoot in another direction. Let's fix that. Back in our script, after we add a force, we're gonna want to set our isIdle equal to false because now we're moving. Then our if statement here will be what sets it back to true. Now when we play test, we can shoot the ball, and while it's moving, I won't be able to aim again. However, there's a sneaky bug in here, so if I shoot it really slow, I'll be able to shoot it while it's moving. The issue here is that we're doing everything in an update, but we're also doing physics methods like add force. So to make our updates run at the same time as the physics time step, instead of using update, we'll just use fixed update. Now when I play test, you can see that I don't get that bug. And that's basically all there is to it. We're going to be doing a mini series on this mini golf prototype. So if that's something you're interested in, make sure to subscribe and hit that notification bell, so be alerted when the next video in the series goes live. And as always, you can check the description down below for the line force script that we created in this video. And I'll see you in the next one.